shirt. Goddamn. You didn't even move it. You just touched it for a second.
No, see, it's good now.
Oh, it's perfect now.
Yeah.
My head looks enormous, and I look like a fucking dork. Could you?
I look sexy as. I look sexy as fuck. Ugh. I wish I had my headphones in right now, but I don't. So.
So you'd be able to hear how cool your voice sounds?
Yeah, I would.
What were we talking about just before?
Howie. Oh, I know you. The owner of this fine establishment.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I felt bad. I felt like I ran him off a little bit.
I mean, he can come join the podcast. It's just we don't have enough mics for him and the puppies. Look at the puppies.
Oh, man.
I'm just going to be staring right in the... What's that one's name?
That's Monkey.
Monkey?
Yeah. Don't look at me like that. He looks like a fucking monkey. Look at him.
You named the black one Monkey?
He looks like a monkey. Look at him. He's got skinny little... So gross.
Okay. What's the pug's name?
That's Petunia.
Petunia?
Yep. Either that or Prima. She's got a few names.
That's okay. It's okay.
Prima, Petunia. All right. That's enough of that shit.
Shark Tank and the Biscuit. On the board or at the board?
At the board.
At the board with Derek and Blake today.
Yeah.
I was thinking if we have guests in the future, which we'll get at least maybe Husted next week.
In my head, it felt like this was a solo episode because it was just us.
Yeah.
But then I was like, that's weird.
What?
Like we got codependent real quick or something, you know what I mean? Like a solo episode. It takes two people to be a solo episode.
I mean, if it would still be a solo. I mean, we don't have guests.
What people don't understand is it's not Shark Tank and the Biscuit.
It's currently just the Biscuit?
No.
We're missing the Shark Tank?
No, it's just the Shark Tank now.
Oh, we're the Shark Tank?
Yeah, there's no Biscuits.
Wait, are you saying that you think the rest of the people are the Biscuit? I thought we were Biscuits inside of a Shark Tank of people.
No, we're the Shark Tank. Oh, jeez, okay. We have been going about this. You've been pulling, and I'm pulling, but in opposite directions.
I finally understand it. So we're the Shark Tank. We're supposed to be mean?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, not mean, just brutal, vicious.
Brutally honest?
Angry and evil is generally the...
Are we going to be able to fill a full hour without Phil Husted here?
You have notes, right?
I do have notes about
my
family.
Talk about your grandma.
And you're going to immediately be like, I don't want to talk about your family.
No, what was your? We were talking about your grandma. You took you guys out to eat ethnic food, right?
So she took us to Prospectors, which is like American food.
What?
I got mac and cheese. Yesterday, I went with my parents, not my grandparents, to a different dinner where we got Mexican food. I eat dinner with my family sometimes, Derek.
This is the wrong story. You told me.
Oh, I told you two different stories.
No, you combined them.
So my grandma took my extended family out to the restaurant Prospectors as a thank you for helping move her into a trailer park.
This is just how little I pay attention.
100%.
I sewed those seamlessly.
Yeah, you did.
Into one story.
You just took the Mexican food from the one story to. Anyway, so my grandma, we moved her into a trailer park. You called her a piece of shit.
No, I was just making sure I remembered what I was going to say.
Yeah.
That's like a bookmarker.
Yeah, so.
That's like if you were in my phone book, I would put Blake, you
piece
know,
of shit.
Piece of shit. And then I would know which Blake I'm talking about.
Ah, okay.
I fraternize with a lot of Blakes.
I'm sorry.
So the B's in my phone is just.
So growing up, some people want to have like unique names, and like some people want to have like. You know, like usual names. I like Blake is a nice one where I've known Blakes, but not too many.
And they're all garbage.
They are entirely. Yeah. It took me years. I was like, why is every Blake I've ever met a piece of shit except me? And then I realized I'm not the exception.
Yeah. You're you prove the rule.
Yeah, I'm just also a piece of shit. So, no, I was at a comedy show this weekend, and the middle performer was talking about naming their son. They named their son Maximus. I was like, that's a horrible name.
It's a strong name, huh?
Yeah. But it's that kid. I would beat the shit out of that kid. I wouldn't. I'd get beat up by Maximus. Stop licking my microphone, dogs.
All right. So your grandma took you to eat.
So we moved her into this this old folks trailer park community because her like best friend lived there, and the house right across the street.
But it wasn't
up.
A house.
It was a trailer. The trailer across the
dirt. Is it a trailer or is
path.
It like a park model sort of thing? Where
it like doesn't have wheels. It's
nice
like
park model.
from the road, you could tell it's a trailer park, but like driving through, you're like, oh, it's just weirdly boxy houses.
Little tiny houses for old people because they're tiny and they don't move around a lot.
So like there's like a carport like built into the side of it.
Yeah, they're beautiful. I love one.
Yeah.
Can I have one?
No. But from like half mile away, you're like, wow, that's a sketchy looking trailer park. But up close, you're like, oh, they can't outrun me. Yeah, so it's cool.
It's real nice.
I could murder any one of them. Anyway, so my grandma moves into the house right across the street from her best friend.
Can I interrupt you for a second?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is the part of the story. Because you already told me this story earlier.
Yes.
And then I had a response for it.
Yes.
But I had forgotten the response until you got to this part of the story. Yeah. Now I don't want to listen to the rest of the story in order to respond. But
go ahead.
No.
I didn't want to tell the rest of the story.
But we actually have to hear the rest of the story in order for my response to make sense.
Okay.
So if you notice,
you're just going to zone out?
Yeah, if you notice that I get glassy-eyed, maybe drool a little bit.
And then I'll nudge you when I'm done?
Yeah, just be like, okay, say that thing now.
Okay.
No, so your grandma.
My grandma, we move her into this.
Best friend.
In, across the lane from her best friend. Not lifelong. I think they've known each other for
80.
Maybe 60 years.
60 years.
I don't know. That's not that long.
That's not very long.
It's not long when you're.
In the scheme of things.
When you're 70.
When you compare it to trees or rocks or something.
You know, other things as old as my grandma.
Yeah, she is old. Man, wow, that bitch so old.
She doesn't know what YouTube is. That's not actually that old. Derek doesn't even know what YouTube is.
That's the worst burn I've ever heard.
Yeah, I'm not good at making people uncomfortable. Well, I'm good at making people uncomfortable.
Man, that bit.
So.
Man, that bit. Man, my that grandma bitch so moved. Old. Man, that bitch so old. That I don't have anything. I'm not creative.
That bitch so old. She got velociraptor herpes. I don't know. Is that a thing? Velociraptor herpes. It doesn't roll off the tongue.
I don't think people.
Much
and
like
dinosaurs.
Velociraptor dick, it rolls right off the tongue.
I don't think people hung out with dinosaurs. Really,
they didn't.
Right?
Okay, are you trying to? When I was being scientifically
that
accurate,
bitch so old that when she. I'm getting closer.
Her first husband left her for Cro-Magnon man. I don't know.
Nice.
That's anthropologically accurate.
Nice. Man, that bitch so old. She,
her oldest sister's name was Lucy, as in the first full skeleton of Australopithecus africanus ever discovered by man.
You know what I liked about that one is it wasn't wordy at all. Like, it was really easy to digest, you know? That's what I like the best about it. He's so cold right now. My dog's an idiot.
Which one, the little one?
Yeah. Man, that bitch so old, she, that bitch so old. My grandma, I used to have a great grandma, and that bitch was so old that she would make a potato salad and then freeze the leftovers. And then in order to get ready to eat the leftovers, she'd just set the frozen bowl of potato salad out by the heater and let it sit there all day.
I don't know if that's an old thing or just not good.
She's
like,
old.
Like health standards. Is she older
Man,
than the FDA?
So she freezes potato salad, set that shit out by the heater all day long. Try to. Oh, man. I can't believe I can't come up with one good. That bitch
Yo,
so
man,
old.
That bitch so old. I don't like saying bitch. Man, that lady's
Call
so
her a whore.
Old.
That man, that whore so old.
What if I drop a C-bomb?
Whore. Man, that cunt so
Whoa!
Old.
We can't publish this to YouTube. We can. No one's watching.
Cunt?
That's one of
We cunt?
What?
We cunt do it. Nobody's watching.
We're Australian.
It just
good
sounds
day.
Like bidet.
I said good day, not bidet. You have a shitty hearing.
Bidet.
Because it's a butt cleaning thing.
Butt cleaner.
Oh,
if
man.
I had a bidet.
So my grandma moved into the trailer across the lane from her best friend.
Yeah.
And then as soon as my grandma did that, her best friend moved away.
All right. I have a similar story.
That story was not worth the 5 minutes of trying to come up
man,
with.
Man, that bitch so old. She
can live in an over 55 community.
I got it. That bitch so old. Her first car was the wheel. Just the wheel.
Man, that bitch so old. She's almost as old as Derek. Oh, look at that. I don't know.
Zingo. Man, that bitch so
old. Is that
our
catchphrase?
What?
Is that our catchphrase now? Who said Zingo on that episode? I didn't watch.
It was a group thing.
Oh, I mean, we all said Zingo, but like, who came up with it?
I don't know. Probably me. I'm like, it's pretty much the driving force.
Sure wasn't Josh?
Comedic, inspirational force behind.
He asked for a link to that video, and then I watched, the viewer number never went up.
It's like I just wanted the link. I didn't want to actually watch it. It's, come on, little fella. All right, that bitch so old. That bitch so old, she still got a MySpace page. That bitch so old, she... Her fur... That... She... That bitch... She... Get... I don't got nothing.
What was your response to my grandma driving her friend out of the community?
So, I had this dog, right?
Okay.
And that bitch was so old. No, okay, check it out. I had this dog. My, it was a little guy like this guy, but a chihuahua.
Chihuahua.
A chihuahua.
Is that what a child would call their lady bits?
No, it was a chihuahua. He was a chihuahua. He was this really old chihuahua, right? Like 14 years old, something like that. And he was my sister's dog.
Okay.
And we came up here. He had this really special relationship with my girlfriend. Like, he really loved her a lot.
Okay.
You know? So we came up here. We were living in an RV at the time.
Oh.
Came up here, and my sister was like, this dog is annoying. She had just had a kid. She's like, do you want to take him? Right?
Okay.
And we were like, cool. Yeah, we'll take him. And then we left here with him. We went to Arizona. It was nice, hot, beautiful, wonderful, warm, chihuahua, old chihuahua weather. He just loved it. He'd stretch out in the sun. Oh, and just, oh, ha. Oh. That's my old chihuahua. Just jizzing in the sun.
Okay, I don't want to do that impression anymore.
It's like a like sprinkler. Yeah. it's just lots of jizz out of this dog. He was a little one, too. But she loves it. It's like, what is that thing? But
good sound?
Yeah, she's got good mic presence. So anyway, we're down there for like... 3 years, right?
Okay.
He's fine. He's going great. He loves it, right?
Okay.
And then we pack up the car one day and we move back up here.
Did you forgot the dog?
No.
Oh.
He's an even better story. You got to remember, this is related to your grandma's story. We pack up the car. We move back up here. We get here and we are staying at my sister's house, which is his old house.
Okay.
And it's like March. Or something, right? You know, March.
Yeah.
And right when we showed up, 1 week later, he was like, nope, and died. He's like, I'm not doing this.
He fucking hated
I'm
that.
I'm out
house.
Of here.
It's like, yep, I finally escaped, and you bring me back?
Bring me back. He's like, nah, fuck it.
So my grandma's friend didn't die, just for the clarity.
Oh, she died.
Oh, probably. Hopefully.
Yeah.
No.
It's sort of the same story.
Sort of.
Except for mine was better.
It was.
It was longer, too.
I didn't want to tell the story.
I left out a whole bunch of stuff.
Do you want to tell more?
It was 3 whole years. I could spend 3 years reciting everything. That
Tuesday,
happened.
December 25th, I spent entirely
alone.
Just
by myself.
Sitting in the desert.
No, actually, one Christmas, Angela went up to visit her kids in Washington. And so I stayed with the chihuahua. Frodo was his name.
Oh.
And
you're
I stayed
so cool.
with him and with her. Down there by myself, all by myself. And I forgot to go shopping before Christmas. So I had to go to some weird barbecued meat stand, which is the only thing that was open in Yuma, Arizona on Christmas. And I got a whole big old pile of meat. And the guy was like, I threw extra in there because you're real pathetic and shitty. And meat and beans. And just sat there and ate them and watched.
You got extra sad
seven.
Christmas meat?
Do you remember that movie, The Magnificent Seven?
The old one or the new one?
The new one. What about Yojimbo? That was the original Magnificent Seven.
I thought that was the original Star Wars.
Probably parts of it.
Is that the one about the bodyguard? The Kira Kurosawa?
Like kind of thing.
And he goes into town and he kills a bunch of these people?
Yeah, and then they it's like two gangs in the town.
Yeah, that's Star Wars is a sci-fi version of Yojimbo mixed with The Searchers. Which is a cowboy movie.
Mixed with your titties.
No.
That bitch so old, she got... That bitch so old, she got pine cones for curlers. Oh, see, there's that problem that I have where
Your dog's like, running away.
I don't care. I don't like that one. Oh, wow. I only like this one.
This one's fun.
This one over here.
This is the one that was glaring at me when I came walked by.
He's looking for, he's hungry. They're hungry. I haven't fed him for days. Watch this. Want to see something? Prima, you hungry? Oh, you are. You hungry? Like, I'm starving to death, Papa. She calls me Papa in my head.
Is that a weird thing? Bring your dogs every
They're good. They're good guests, you know. Do you have dogs?
Much better than Aaron Hall.
Yeah. Oh, man. Oh, snap. I want to punch him in his fucking nose.
He actually has content, though, so that's good.
I know. He needs we haven't gotten through any of my notes.
I didn't have that story about my grandma on my notes.
I know. Wait, I made you added it. What's on your notes? You want to hear what I did this week?
Sure.
I didn't do shit. I just wanted to interrupt.
So I went to the casino with my family last night because we're white trash garbage.
Do something else besides hang out with your family.
I don't like them.
Go hang out with Aaron Hall.
I don't want it.
At the weird
sex dungeon parties.
You know that's not true. He doesn't do any of that shit. You go hang out with him, he'd be like, I actually just go to Dave and Buster's.
I met his girlfriend one time.
I met her a bunch of times. She's a pug. It died.
Oh.
They got a new one. It's a rough move.
Oh, she has a pug. I think you said she is a pug. I was like, what? I thought she was a lady.
She's a Aaron Hall's girlfriend is a pug.
I think he's brought her to like shows and stuff before.
Yeah, she's nice.
Yeah.
She's like rough, tough, kind of tough, rough. Rough, tough, and rough.
Somehow this podcast is going even better than when we have guests.
I know, it's weird. It's almost like all the guests are hindrance because they're all fucking pieces of shit. I hate them.
Every so we're just now talking shit about...
Every comic in Spokane is a fucking pile of human garbage.
Everyone that calls himself a comic in Spokane is a piece of shit.
Oh, zingo. Bung, 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 bung.
So I think my dad thinks I'm depressing. Yeah. Depressed now?
Depressed.
Because... we were at the casino and we parked and we were walking across the street at the to get to the to where the casino is, and there was a bus.
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, should we wait for the bus to go by? He's like, there's a stop sign. I'm like, I don't think there's a stop sign. So we just walked out in front of this bus and it had to slam on its brakes.
Yeah.
And he's like, I guess there isn't a stop sign. I'm like, what's the worst that could happen? We just get hit by a bus? He's like, yeah, probably. That's pretty funny. And so I was like, you know how much money we'd get if we got hit by a city bus in a crosswalk? Oh, man, it'd be great. And he's like, well, money doesn't bring back everything. Money doesn't give you, like, a like
legs.
Yeah, doesn't bring your legs back. I was like, robot legs.
Yeah, robot legs.
Robot legs. And he just, like, looked at me and just, like, walked away.
He was like, I can't believe this grown man came out of my balls. Just
fully formed.
He's got the
Superman pose out of his dick.
He's got the memory of that day. He's like, you can't. Money doesn't bring everything back, son.
You don't trust me. I didn't have enough money to get rid of you.
Look, I put a hat on him.
That dog is adorable. The worst thing about this podcast is you can't see the puppy. Yeah.
He's like plotting to kill you right now. It's ridiculous. If you moved a little too fast, he would fucking murder you. Like, if we high-fived right now, he would tear your throat out. Yeah, he doesn't care. He hates me.
He didn't do anything.
If I high-five Angela, he threatens me bodily.
I think he just doesn't like you.
I know he doesn't. He adores me, and that's different. If you like somebody, it's one thing. If you love somebody, it's one thing. But if you adore somebody and you idolize their masculinity and their power, then it's completely different. You know what I'm talking about? And that's what his problem is I'm like a god. I'm like the bad god. And Angela's the good god. Good god. You heard that Korn song, Good God? This is going really well.
I've not heard that Korn song.
You ever heard that song?
I don't listen to Korn.
They ripped off that Machine Head song. You know that Machine Head song? It's the one that goes...
I know a Machine Head song. I don't know what song I know. All I can think of is Machine Head by Bush.
Oh, yeah. That's a terrible song.
That's a different thing.
I remember that used to play on MTV all the time, and I'd be like, oh, this again? God damn it. Because that's how you had to do MTV, was sit around and wait for them... Did you ever have MTV with music videos? I know that's hack.
I never.
You never knew.
Guess
MTV?
What I watched as a child. What was my go-to thing to watch
on
TV?
Like on TV?
Like genre of thing.
Well, I would say
car commercials. Were you about to say car commercials? Man, those Kia Sentra commercials were amazing.
They're so good.
Ah, it's reliable.
No, what was I gonna say? I was gonna say game shows.
I liked Win Ben Stein's Money.
Ugh, I hate that guy.
Yeah.
No, he's all right.
I liked his Visine commercials, wasn't it? Visine? No, Clear Eyes.
Clear Eyes gets the red out. That wasn't very good. Can you do a better impression?
No.
Bueller. No.
Bueller.
No, he doesn't. It's not low. It's like Bueller.
Bueller.
That was a good one.
Bueller.
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 Have you seen Willow?
I think it's like the fifth time you've asked me. No.
And you still haven't watched it?
No.
I can't do it. Willow. The one. You haven't seen Willow? It's got Val Kilmer in it. It's got...
You know how many Val Kilmer movies I've seen in my life?
How many?
One and a half.
I rented a movie one time because it had Val Kilmer on the cover.
And I only think I've seen that Batman movie all the way through.
That's the only one?
And half of the Doors movie.
Oh, man. You're missing out. There's at least one other good one. I rented a movie because I thought it had Val Kilmer on the cover. And I was like, cool, I'm going to watch this movie with Val Kilmer. Name, face, whole cover, Val Kilmer. And in the movie, he was like, hey, and then somebody shot him. And then they just carried his body around.
Oh, is it one of those movies where like it was before he became famous?
No,
and they re-released it once he was famous to capitalize?
Nope. He was super famous the whole time.
Or like any of those shitty C-list movies that Paris Hilton did, and it would like have her as the top cast member, but she was like nobody.
Yeah, not even.
Nobody.
She just showed up.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've actually listened. I was listening to a lot of...
Did you know most of Paris Hilton's money is self-made? She's made like no money from the Hilton brand. Most of her money is from her DJing.
Yeah. Yeah, I buy that.
She makes $1 million a night to DJ.
That works. I mean, that tracks.
I did not make that much.
Could I have $1 million?
If I had $1 million. I don't know the rest of it.
What else is on your stupid fucking list? God damn it. It actually says topics for the podcast.
It does.
Oh, my God.
So
what if you just tell me what's written down on it, and then I'll talk about that? Because I don't want to hear your
kids
story.
Suck at art.
They do. Oh man, kid art is it's the worst.
Hack comedy. Alert. They all be like scratching the page with their crayons and the bippity boppities. Am I doing a really bad?
That bitch is so young. That art is terrible.
No, when I was at the dinner with my extended family, my uncle was there with his grandkid.
This is at Aztec?
This was at Prospectors.
I can't get it straight.
Yeah, it's almost like trying. You're not paying attention. it's almost like, who gives a shit? Anyway, like this kid was coloring this paper, but it was like a coloring, like, kids activity thing. But
yeah, I'm familiar.
He was just taking a purple crayon and just scribbling the entire thing purple. No, like, not even attempting to within the lines. Just every inch of it was purple.
Uh-huh.
And then, so my uncle was like, oh, it looks so great. And I just want to be like, that's shit. What the fuck are you doing? Kid garbage. Don't
but
encourage
not,
this kid.
But not at the table. Like, gets up to go to the bathroom. You follow him in there. like, hey,
the
nice
fuck you
tiny
doing?
Dick and your art sucks, you faggot. I
actually,
hate you.
The kid has a huge dick.
Really? Like, you've got a flopper, huh?
Like a whoopunk. Like, he can use the adult urinal.
But he's like 7 inches too short. Yeah. He's got an.
Like it can hit himself in the chin with his dick. No,
and he's got a brace he has to wear.
It's like a bra, but for his dick.
it's a child sized dick. That's the name of this episode, by the way. Child sized dick bra.
No, so my uncle was like, "Oh, you've filled up this entire sheet." So he tried to turn it over to the blank side of the paper, and the kid's like, "No. I'm drawing I go, what are you, an idiot? I'm coloring in the picture."
Yeah.
But he was...
How old is this kid anyway?
Like 16? I don't know.
Ooh, that's way too old.
It was like 3 or 4.
Ew, that's way too young.
To talk about his dick, yeah, definitely.
No, no, I mean just to exist.
I think you have to be three or four.
People get all upset when kids die. I don't think it's that big of a deal. Do you?
I mean, you can always make a new one.
Yeah, exactly. That's why I heard that there's this, I might have just made this up. I think it was Indians, Native Americans. Somebody had a thing where they didn't get too upset if somebody who was under 14 died because your soul isn't ready.
I mean, then. Pre like 1900, everybody, you had like a 1 in 4 chance of surviving childhood. So
that's pretty good odds.
They're like, he died.
What are the odds now?
Pretty good.
1 in 2.
I think most people.
Or wait,
do you know many kids that have died?
I don't know how odds work. Now that I'm thinking about it.
Half of all kids die. Isn't that how it works now?
God,
no.
Damn it. So many kids live now.
Yeah, it's awful.
Isn't it crazy? It's like, it's a weird thing. Oh, it actually kind of makes sense now that I think about it.
Half of all kids dying?
No, like, never mind. Who cares?
No, did you ever hear that, like, they say, like, the life expectancy used to be like 30 years?
30 years.
But what that really was, yeah, because people would live to 70.
There was wizards.
No. Most people lived like 70 if they live past 8. Yeah. So it's just a whole bunch of baby deaths offset how long you live. So that's the average age life expectancy is entirely based on how many babies die.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's really good. I like the idea of young people.
Oh, so I was talking to the I was at the comedy club on Saturday.
Should brag about it.
You're
gonna go see Damon Wayans?
Yeah, probably next week.
You kind of have to, right?
I mean,
I've heard he's good.
I'm there almost every Saturday, and if I skip the one black guy,
I thought you were punching that card this weekend.
That's right. It was Craig Robinson.
He's fairly black on the outside.
Yeah,
gleaming white on the inside, though.
Yeah, he did sing a lot. Did black guys sing?
Yeah, of course. That's what they're known for.
Whoa.
All black guys are known for.
They actually have never met a black guy that couldn't sing.
Well,
Does he try?
All the time. Remember, I'd kicked him off a couple of times.
Oh, yeah. We have a record of that. No, but they were telling me, one of the guys there was asking me.
Does that say Larry's cow?
Yeah, it's my Uncle Larry has a cow that, I have a story about it. But anyway, I was just going to make fun of him and his cow. They were telling me, Gilbert Gottfried's coming up,
Yeah.
And last time he was here, it was the most people they've ever had walk out on a comedian.
Really?
And they brought him back. They're bringing him back.
He's gnarly, huh?
I can't, because he's like, oh, that's the Aflac guy.
Yeah.
I've heard of Gilbert Gottfried. Who hasn't?
So dirty.
And nobody knows why they know of him other than the Aflac thing.
And he's so filthy.
Oh, it's
disgusting. He's filthy in like the most hilariously like goofy way. You seen that? There's a joke where he talks about being at the beach and seeing a shark and stuff, and everybody freaks out, and it's so fucking funny. It goes on for like 10 minutes. He's like, so you're trying to beat the shark off? Well, you're not trying to beat the shark off. That would attract more sharks if you just started giving out shark hand jobs. Can you do a Gilbert Gottfried? I can't. I feel like I should be able to.
It's like a hype.
No, it's really high.
And it's got a like a nasally.
Yeah.
Oh, but it's like a softer. It's not like a harsh nasally.
Iago the parrot.
Is that him?
Yeah, from
Aladdin?
Aladdin, yeah. Come on, Jafar. I can't even get close to it. You going to go see Gilbert Gottfried?
Yeah.
Me too.
He's only here for 2 nights, though.
I'm going to see him and Mark Norman. That'll be
Is
nice.
Norman the Sunday of...
No, Sunday before.
Is it the Sunday before?
Yeah. Which is, like, next Sunday.
I thought next week was Damon Wayans.
I don't know what's going on with my life. Keep getting fatter.
Yeah, you do, you fat ass.
Just because I keep eating hamburgers every
day. Actually, there's a lot of African-American comedians coming. Roy Wood Jr. is coming up.
You going to go see Roy Wood Jr.?
Oh, definitely.
He's the one that took over This Isn't Happening.
This Is Not Happening, from Ari Shaffir.
Comedy Talk.
Huh, it's weird. It's like that's the thing we have in common to talk about.
Wow. I was listening to that podcast you told me about. Hey, let's talk about a podcast on our podcast. What? Like a bunch of fucking...
No one watches this garbage anyway.
Dildos.
Yeah, so it's Jeremy Piven this Friday and Saturday, and then Mark Norman on Sunday.
You want to go see Jeremy Piven?
100%.
I have to go see it.
I'm a big fan of Entourage. I'm just going to be like...
I heard it's really bad.
Oh, every time I've ever heard him brought up in like a podcast with like real people that are funny,
yeah.
He's the example of someone garbage. That is only doing comedy because they can't get an acting job anymore.
Yeah. Because he's a huge piece of shit.
Yeah, I've heard that he's left, instead of tips at restaurants, signed copies of Entourage on DVD.
Nice.
Which is great. I want a signed copy of Entourage, but signed by him, not any of the main characters.
I actually feel like it would be a good, I feel like I would actually approach him and be like, hey, man, I'm a huge fan. I was nervous about coming over. But
you've been there before. There's always the comics that hide in the room because they don't want to talk to the scum.
Us.
He's one of those people.
Oh, he hides.
He definitely is. I remember, who was there for? Who's the guy from Whose Line Is It Anyway?
Greg Proops.
Greg Proops?
Yeah.
Were you there?
I was there.
Oh, yeah, and he was wandering around.
Why don't you tell me the story about the thing that happened when I was there? It's
That's
a good
super
story.
Weird. I totally forgot you were there because you left right away. And he was just wandering around the whole, like,
Such
before the show started, hoping people would be like, hey, look, it's Greg. But nobody was.
I wish I would have talked to him because I only came to see him because he was so, like, bitchy and, oh, here we go. Shh. Everybody relax.
Okay.
All right. That was a good dog break. I only came to see him because he was
Dog
so
Tug.
Dog Tug with Aaron Blake and the Biscuit Shit. Darren Flake and the Biscuit Dip.
Probably Giga
Bada. Do you know what I like at a party? A lot of dip.
That's a good dip.
Various dips.
You know, oh, man. You know what? I'm going to go on my way home. What time is it? Is it 8 o'clock? 7:40. I'm going to go stop by Safeway and get some five-layer dip and some chips, and I'm going to eat some five-layer dip tonight.
Yeah, I could imagine that. Just kind of sitting there in your basement bedroom, sitting on your bed eating chips and dip.
Watching something stupid on Netflix.
No, not watching anything.
Batman.
Just, hey, you know what? You want to hear a story. No.
Now it's time for a sponsor break. This episode is brought to you somehow by the Checkerboard Bar.
Five-layer chips and dip. This is the
They don't have five-layer dip, do they? Do they have five-layer dip here?
No, not here.
Can we talk to Chris and get some five-layer dip?
No, man. You don't want to get that shit from...
bar. This bar?
From any bar.
Just a loose dip sitting out on the bar. Just
like just I think we got some back here somewhere. Let's crack open a
No,
can.
It's just always sitting out. I didn't put that there. I've owned this bar for 10 years. I don't know where that came from.
Ghost dips. Yeah.
It's been there the entire time.
This is the first podcast from the Checkerboard. Technically live.
I guess.
We have dogs.
I can figure out how to live stream from my laptop.
Everything is a suspect at this point. Anyway.
I'll mess around and see if I can
Checkerboard
YouTube
bar
live from.
Doing the thing at the checker. What?
Physically.
You're not at the checkerboard?
Why aren't you guys at the checkerboard? Are you not
what?
That creepy guy sitting on the stool?
You're
or
not here?
The other creepy guy sitting on the different stool but who's talking to the bartender?
Didn't you know this is the place to be on Monday night? I haven't advertised at all. I'm going to advertise.
Yeah, you should really not stop me from advertising to people.
I haven't told anybody.
I told Jay Berg.
I told
and Brian.
I told
Did you also tell Brian?
David Anderson.
Why would you tell David Anderson?
Because he's the bad dude. I wanted him to show up. He didn't show up. There's probably like five people sitting in the bar.
She
like,
won't be great. I heard there was an open mic.
Yeah, what is going on here?
This is, I don't know who I'm doing an impression of, but
comedy. Wonk, wonk. Can you do any Spokane comedy impressions?
I mean, my D. Abrams is racist.
Is pretty good, yeah. What... If I do
Nobody else has a good voice.
The problem is if I do D. Abrams' impression, it gives away all of his material because it's just that one bit. What was that bit anyway? I can't remember now.
I raise box turtles. Money's good, but it's slow.
Oh, I raise box turtles. Man, Jesus, that was really racist.
I did some time for racing box turtles. Money was good, but it was slow.
See the boozing. No, what was that one we were talking about the other day? Everybody was doing it. It's all over that other podcast, isn't it?
What? what bit does he have? Oh, he couldn't mass shoot with a. You have to be a motivated motherfucker to mass shoot with a musket.
You gotta be a motivated
motherfucker.
Mass shoot. You gotta be a motivated motherfucker to mass murder with a musket.
Mass murder.
You gotta be a motivated. You know what I'm thinking?
You know I wrote that joke for him? It was like a 5-minute bit. And then he turned it into 5 words.
All you need is some sweet alliteration. I did notice at one point he just started moving on from there. Because he used to go on and on, and then he's just like, oh. Yeah, I'd be a motivated motherfucker to mass murder the musket.
He was trying to tell me, because we were
olives.
We were doing this whole act out of, like, trying to, like, shoot people and then reload the musket by taking the ramrod. And it's just like, no, hold on. I still got to kill all of you. And he's like, you need to do that on stage. That was a bad. You need to do that on stage. You need to do that on stage.
Yeah, it's crazy because that is super racist, but it's also accurate.
He does just have.
He's got, like, a lot of energy, like I'm gonna.
You know what it reminds me of? Look too much like a mass
Have
shooter
you ever put
too.
Garlic in a garlic press, and pressed it, and it squeezes out, or like Play-Doh, in the Play-Doh extruder, and it squeezes out into a shape. That's what it reminds me of whenever D talks to me. Like he's just a weird extruding machine, and his words.
You know,
are
you really shouldn't talk trash about him. Because
I can't help it.
He's one of the few people willing to book you in town.
No, he's not. He's one of the few people willing to talk about it. Nobody else will even
about it. You got to be careful. What's weird is how many booker people in town have been like, "Yeah, you are unbookable, but you're hilarious."
Keep up the good work and go fuck myself. Own it. Do any of these fucking idiots.
Let's talk to the club and see if we can't put together a Shark Tank in the Biscuit
pod.
And we could do a live pod slash comedy show.
Live pod at the comedy club?
Yeah, instead of this shitty venue.
Live pod at the comedy club. This place rules, man. I like this place way better than the clubs.
Wish we had people.
Well, there's only 80 here, but.
How long have we been going at this?
Not long enough.
Probably not.
It's been 10 minutes, probably. Ooh, I had a story.
About half an hour.
Oh, God, it's felt like an eternity.
I know, God, fucking A.
I had a thing. What were we talking about?
We were doing impressions of local people.
We're talking about the checkerboard bar.
Oh, yeah, the delightful checkerboard bar.
We're here at the checkerboard bar.
I assume their drinks are good. I've heard good things on Google reviews.
Yeah, I did a lot of Google reviews. wait, you know what this is like?
We're in a gazebo. What is it like?
I was going to say that this isn't, because you were going to say this is the new home of the Shark Tank and the Biscuit pod, but it's not. It's like this is dad's house after the divorce.
It does feel like a divorced dad home, right? You know, especially since all they can see is a barrel and a tarp.
Exactly.
And we keep talking to dogs that are off screen. Yeah, the dogs. The dogs don't like us, but they're there.
They're actually going to start coming with me to the club, too.
Yeah, they don't allow that. Have you seen the dog that hangs out at the comedy club? One of the managers brings their dog with them.
Oh, sirs?
What?
Sirs?
Is that the name of the dog?
No, I was saying serious. Like a little
sirs? I don't know who sirs is.
Sirs?
You know, they keep it in the office. And, like, during shows, it's gotten out and, like, run into the...
Yeah, I have seen that dog.
Yeah, it's a nice dog.
When I went and saw Tony Hinchcliffe, there was a woman in the audience. With a dog.
Mm.
A very attractive woman with a dog. And he was like, what is going on? And she's like, I'm training this dog to be a service dog.
Wait, so it's not even a certified service dog?
No,
it's
just training
that doesn't count.
She brought him to a comedy show.
That's actually pretty good to train the dog.
Yeah.
He
made a crass joke.
Yeah, that's why he's not welcome at the club anymore. You not on my
he
podcast.
He said a thing on the latest Kill Tony that was super comic thing. Because, you know, when they came through here, it
mm-hmm.
was like, you have to buy tickets to go to the show.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, even if you're a comic and stuff. He said this thing. It was great. It was, he's like, if you're a comic, you don't have to buy a ticket to the show. You can come sign up and then just wait in the lobby. Call your name. You can come up. I was like, oh, man, I wish I would have known that.
That's, I mean, I totally get it, because if he didn't make everyone that wanted to participate pay.
That's so good, though. That's such a funny.
The club would have probably preferred if he wouldn't have said that.
Yeah.
But no, I was listening to some podcast talk with Blake and Derek.
Podcast talk.
No, it was an interview with Dave Attell.
Hey, yo, dog, I heard you like podcasts.
And
we put some podcast talk inside your podcast so you can listen
basically,
to a podcast.
You
want to
hear two white guys summarize other podcasts that they listen to, but on a podcast you can't just listen to, you have to also watch, because for some reason I haven't set up that SoundCloud account yet.
Yeah, boy.
Shark Tank and the Biscuit.
It's a podcast within a podcast within a podcast within another.
Rocket Talk.
It's the podcast.
I think Rocket Talk was way better than this garbage.
Yeah, no doubt.
Rocket Talk had fans.
That only lasted for like three quarters of an episode, though.
Yeah. So they're interviewing Dave Attell, and they were telling him that he's like,
I look like fucking built. Like an arm wrestling champion or something.
They were saying that Dave Attell is a comics just comic, so where all comics, like a lot of most comics, look up to Dave Attell as a good influence. And he's like, yeah, it's always great to have fans that don't pay for the show.
Oh wait, I heard that one. That wasn't Dave Attell. Was it?
I was listening to a Dave Attell interview, so he stole it. That fucking hack.
Dave Attell's a hack. Dave Attell's like the most comic. Dave Attell is so. Such a good, nice comic that he actually goes out on tour with Jeff Ross and does shows.
I'm not a fan of Jeff Ross.
Jeff Ross is garbage, is what I'm saying. Dave Attell's like, well, I guess I'll carry all
this. I liked the bumping mics because it was half Dave Attell.
Yeah.
It was half good.
It was like half fire and half shit. The fire and shit tour.
I briefly talked to Dave Attell when he was in town. I was hanging out at the back of the comedy club, and he walked by, and he's like, hey. And I was like,
he just went, hey.
But really, he was trying to walk past me to go smoke, and I was in his way.
He's like, hey, get the fuck out of my way.
And it was probably like he saw me from like 20 feet away, just like staring at him. Is that Dave Attell? Is that Dave Attell?
Podcast talk with Blake and Derek.
That wasn't
a podcast. I'm going into a podcast talk. No, you told me about Unmasked.
Oh, yeah. Did you listen to the Dave Attell episode?
No.
Oh, because that's where I pulled that Dave
Attell.
Really?
No, I couldn't get the Dave Attell episode. There's only a few on my catcher.
Mm.
I listened to the Patrice O'Neill, which is pretty good. I listened to Colin Quinn, fucking hilarious. That's where he said the exact same thing, where he's like, I wish there was 2,000 comedians in every town. So when I went into town, they would all the shows would
I'm not that big a Colin Quinn fan.
Oh, he's fucking hilarious. And then the funniest one, probably one of the funniest podcasts, maybe one of the funniest things I've ever fucking heard, was the Nick DiPaolo episode.
I didn't want to listen to that one.
Holy shit. That was just nonstop from start to finish. That guy was fucking just punch, 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 just murdering, slaughtering, killing, slaying, laying it down, leaving a tan. Flipping those cushions, making it filthy, turning on the brights.
Shark Tank and the Biscuit.
Checking the oil.
At the board.
Yeah.
With Derek and Blake.
He refilled the antifreeze.
We should put something interesting on this table because you can see it. But like, it just looks like a pile of shit right now.
I wish this would work.
Well, that was shitty.
Everything is suspect.
We're singing the song from the Lego movie?
Outlander. Shark Tank and the Biscuit, sponsored by Outlander. On DVD.
Season one. Volume 1. It's not even the full season 1. Gosh.
It's the Starz original. On DVD. Get your copy today and use promo code
Shark Tank and the Biscuit.
And the Biscuit to receive
all one word, no spaces.
15% off.
And if it doesn't work, call your local cable prescriber provider and complain. Tell them Shark Tank and the Biscuit sent you.
Tell them that they sent you.
Outlander, season one, volume one, on DVD.
On DVD. It's It's good.
Fuck. That all scared right. me. My mic bag.
I know. I almost hit the camera, too. That was almost a tragic
That was the most exciting thing that's ever happened on this podcast.
It did get pretty good. My dog's like, what? The other one's dead. He died. That was tragic that my dog died on this episode.
And we didn't even mention it.
It was like 9/11.
It was like 20 minutes ago.
But if only one of the towers got hit.
And it was the tower that you didn't like as much as the other one.
No, it was the one
It's
I
like just if the South Tower got hit.
So 9/11, that's a hot topic.
Oh,
what's what else is on your list there, buddy? It's really carried us through.
My uncle has a farm.
God damn it.
One of his cows died.
How come
his cow
so every time I learn something new about you, it's more boring than the last thing that I learned about you? I grew up on a farm. Wait, is your uncle's farm a functioning farm or just some shithole out in the middle of nowhere?
He has cows and pigs.
He has cow.
One less cow. One just died.
Cows for
And he had it died in the middle of the night, so he had to just dig a grave and bury it.
His cow died and he buried it?
No, so you're not supposed to take the meat from a cow you find dead. It's just because you don't know.
Grind it up and feed it to the other cows.
No. No, that's not at all what you do. Cows. No.
Strong cows.
It died of, prolapsed anus.
No, that's not a good way to go.
It shat out its insides to death.
Oh, man.
He Ooh. Was just driving around out in his field, and he was like, what's that? What's that hanging out of that? I should call a guy about this. And then by the time they could find somebody, it died.
Then
I was at the dinner table while my uncle had to explain to my mother what a prolapsed was.
And they did it at the dinner table?
Oh, yeah, no.
Or were you having to eat? Was it?
I was eating mac and cheese.
Were you having prolapsed anus?
Yeah, it was delicious.
It's delicious. So, okay.
Wait. Apparently the prolapsed anus doesn't taint the meat as much as you think it would.
I wouldn't think so. Now, could you imagine for... Okay.
It pooped its butthole out.
So your uncle, I'm assuming, from all that I know, not bright.
He's not a farmer. He's a dull
bull, right?
So he was a firefighter for like, I don't know, 30 years or something like that. He retired.
That's a lot
and
of
when
years.
He retired, I don't know how long it was, but he retired when he got to retirement age and bought a farm to go farm. And now he raises chickens
and
pigs and cow.
And prolapsed anus.
And the cows shit out their butts.
So you've got... Most cows shit out their
butt. No, shit out their butt. Like, the butthole came out.
I always think of the butt as the cheeks.
Mm.
And the...
The inside part of the butt was outside.
Do cows have butt cheeks?
I don't know.
I know horses do.
You said that like, oh boy, howdy. Do I know that horses have butt cheeks?
If a horse doesn't have butt cheeks, that's a skinny, unhealthy horse.
That's why I like my horses.
That horse is so
You
skinny.
Like him with a little bit of junk in the trunk?
Yeah, a lot of junk in the trunk.
That horse is so skinny, my dick fell right out.
Oh,
even I could fuck in the ass and I have a tiny dick. Is that what you're going to say? Is that what your joke was because you have a tiny dick? I talk about my penis on this podcast more than I talk about it ever. Flump.
Shark Tank and the Biscuit brought to you by Blake Allen's penis, otherwise known as the Biscuit.
The Biscuit.
What are we talking about? Oh, yeah, your uncle. He's an idiot.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Dumb man. Stupid.
What about?
Fucking moron, right?
I don't much like
Complete
him.
Complete
so
idiotic.
You can say whatever you want.
Piece of human trash. I was going to try that as a joke that I identify as just a complete piece of human garbage. So
Most people so identify you as a
complete. I wasn't sure. Anyway, what were we going to say? Oh, yeah, your uncle. Dumb. Stupid man. Fried beans. Completely retarded from years of hose work.
He is gluten free.
Ew. Okay. So.
No, growing up, his family, him and his kids had the worst diet. They would, like, going over to their house, like, to stay over, because, you know, you stay with your cousins when your parents want to have sex in their house without you. You know.
Nice.
Kid things. I assume that's what they were doing. But dinner would be, like, they're like, do you want a hot dog or a hamburger? And I'm like, I'll take a hamburger. And then his kids would be like, I want both of them. And then for a side dish, oh, do you have like, you know, some chips or something? Chicken nuggets and mac and cheese.
That's and a beautiful dinner.
So his family sounds all so gained good. A lot of weight, which I'm not saying anything. I'm fat. I get it. Not as fat as some people. Pug.
Shark taking the biscuit brought to you Ooh. By Derek's enormous Man fat tits. Ass and huge tits.
And so they're like, we need to lose some weight. It's because we're gluten intolerant. No, it's because your side dish was chicken nuggets. That's not a side dish. That's
such a good, like if you could go to McDonald's and get a Big Mac with a side of chicken McNuggets and an ice cream cone, you're like, that's a meal. It's delicious.
Why does my heart hurt? I don't
that's
know.
That's usually why I do it.
It's the gluten.
You gotta think, French fries aren't a very good side dish either. Anyway. Yeah.
Anyway, so he's an idiot.
I had a hamburger dog today.
Hamburger dog?
Sort of.
No, so did you go to 7-Eleven to get the cheeseburger bite?
No, no.
That
no,
is
no, no.
one of the best things
it's
ever.
It's close, though. I had hamburger, but I only had hot dog buns.
Oh.
So I made a big square hamburger, and then I put some buns, and I split it up, so it was...
Oh, I would have just done rolled up a hamburger into a cheeseburger bite.
I don't like touching meat.
Okay.
You got to think about that.
No, so what they would do, they'd cut up their hot dog and put it on the hamburger.
Oh, that's a great idea. Some french fries.
I think Zips sells that.
Yeah. Zips is the tits, bro.
Anyway, so what about my uncle being an idiot?
So your uncle's a dumb person.
Usually.
Slow man. He's no prospects for a normal life.
Yeah.
He's bound to his lazy boy.
God
to,
damn it.
To drool upon him. So is it like 36 minutes?
53 minutes.
Well, that's pretty good. We could probably get
I think the first 10 of that is just rearranging furniture, though.
Yeah.
Well, a half-hour podcast is fine.
Petting puppies.
So, yeah, my uncle's an idiot with no prospects in life, even though he's a retired firefighter.
He's driving around miraculously.
And he sees a prolapsed anus,
yeah. Yeah, and he's like, goo.
Because he can spot a prolapse from a half mile away.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, so it wasn't very surprising?
I assume it's like, why is that red thing hanging out that butt? Ugh. Why was he staring at his cow's butts?
All right, now right imagine a cow, arguably dumber than your uncle.
Okay.
Right? But in this case, is the cow. So he's just standing there, and all of a sudden his asshole starts dribbling out.
No, I think it's like
body.
A
body.
Is that my phone?
Was it? Yeah, it's real professional. Sweet podcast moment right here.
Yeah, there's some sort
Welcome
of news.
Answering phones with Blake Kinder. Rock. And motherfucking DJ Kelly.
Brought to you by Chilled Magazine.
Your idiot uncle. Wait, no, your idiot uncle's dumb cow.
No, yeah, so the way that happens is you push too hard when you're pooping, so the cow's just like, I gotta poop.
That wasn't really... He's like, I'm not a scientist or anything or a doctor. I'm a cow. But I'm pretty sure.
I feel a little constipated. It's like I'm only eating grass and corn.
Yeah.
But
I really shouldn't.
Shouldn't push that hard. You should teach his cows not to push so hard. You should get a squatty potty for the cows.
This dog, he does this weird thing when he goes to take shits. Is he's like, does the taking a dog shit thing, you know, where they...
Yeah.
Squat, but his back legs go out in front of his front legs, and then he goes like this, and walks around all weird. It's the stupidest thing I've ever seen. No prolapses yet. So you're a cow. You're like, I'm gonna just go ahead and take a dumb idiot cow shit
right now,
which is usually just slop.
I
ever seen a hippopotamus take a shit? Do you have internet right now?
On my phone.
Yeah, look it up. Let's look it up. This will be a part. This is. I'll print it on the thing. Put
hippo shitting.
No. Hippo fart. Put in giant hippo fart. That'll put in humongous hippo fart explosion. Yep, that's the one. Okay, play. You got volume. There you go.
That was your duck.
Thank you. thing ever.
It's only halfway done. Is it play it again?
There's nothing funnier than that.
That is. That video is titled World's Biggest Fart.
That's a good one.
That was. I like the tail is flipping the shit around.
No prolapse.
Yeah.
That's solid. That's a healthy watch poop. Videos of goats screaming. Are you going to sit here and tell me you've never seen a goat screaming video? Just type in goat screaming. Quick. This is going to be hilarious. This is one of the funniest things there is in the world. Oh, man.
Goat screaming 10 hours?
Funny goat scream video. It hits me every time. This I'm pretty sure it's funny.
Yeah. Okay. That was something. Right. Oh.
Now look up cute pugs falling asleep.
Oh.
Those goats, I don't know. It gets me every fucking time, man.
That's pretty good.
God,
you watch
it.
A lot of animal videos, don't you?
Oh, boy. Yeah, there's some weird ones. You ever seen a capybara?
I think so.
We should probably save that for next week.
We've got to have some content for the rest of this podcast.
Yeah, pretty much I'm banking 8 or 10 episodes out of capybaras. So it'll be capybara part one. You'd look up capybara eating a tiny cucumber.
Have you seen the hamsters eating mini burritos?
Yes.
That's adorable.
You know what creeps me out?
Burritos eating tiny hamsters.
That is not.
I saw that video. That's a porn video. That's what that is.
Very scary.
By the way, that's what you call a Mexican butthole, a burrito.
I thought it was a hamster.
No, it's a burrito eating a hamster.
Yeah.
Because it's a butthole eating a hamster. It's a hamster going in the butthole.
I call Mexican buttholes guinea pigs.
Well, that's real racist.
Doesn't guinea pig sound like a racial slur? Kinda. Get the fuck out of here, you guinea pig.
Wow.
You guinea pig. She's so snorty. They're so hungry.
You should feed them.
No.
I should get some 7-layer dip.
Oh, you know what I
like?
I
was late to work this morning. Oof.
I like a whole bunch of different dips. So you can get like a little bit of one dip on a chip and then get a little bit more of a different kind of dip on there. Get a couple more on. You just stack up the dips and then you just rub them all over your face. And then you fall asleep in the bathtub. Oh, that was my phone.
There's a lot of families coming and going in this apartment complex watching us do a podcast.
Fuck. Hope you're having fun. When you come home, please bring cookies or sugar in general. I ate soup. Now I need sweet.
You can bring some 5-layer dip. That's pretty sweet.
I'll see if she wants that.
Found some dip at this bar.
5-layer.
This is worse than me checking my phone.
Dip. I'm such a hypocrite. 5-layer. Oh, no. It says give layer dip. 5-layer dip. Welcome to checking your phones with Blake. It's only bad when you do it. It's okay when I do it because I'm cool. I'm a G. You know what G stands for? Hey, what are you looking up?
Is G stand for gangrene?
I think so. I think my dog's going to fall out of this if you move. She's like leaning. You want to hear a dog story? We were living in a van for a while. And so it was in Arizona. So we had both the doors on the van open, you know. And there's a mattress back there. And Angela and Prima, they were crashing out. And I was like, okay, you guys sleep good. Because I had to stay awake crazy, you know, to starve myself of sleep so I don't go into lapse into like psychotic fugue states, you know. So I was like, good night, have a good sleep. I'm gonna force
myself don't know what
stay awake for another 6 hours. So so I'm saying good night, and then and I notice her, she's kind of like, so when she goes to sleep, she sleeps like wicked hard, and I was like, I should move her. And next thing you know, rolls out of the van onto the ground, gets a black eye. Doesn't look like she could get a black eye, but it's all it was all swollen.
I've never heard of a dog getting a black eye.
Yeah, because she thumped her eye. She fell down the stairs, you prick. That's what happened when I took her to the vet. I was like, yeah, she fell out of the van that we're living in down by the fucking river. And she was like, oh, that is what we always hear. I punched her in the face.
You were at the free clinic?
Punch a pug in the face.
I kind of would.
If somebody was like, I got a couple of pugs lined up, and I come over and give them the old 1-2 right in the fucking
I wouldn't door. Hesitate.
Would you uppercut a pug?
I feel like they're too close to the ground.
Well, if it was up on a
oh, like someone's stool. Holding the pug up? Yeah, I could uppercut it. But like if it's just on the ground, I have to like, it's a downward kind of a motion. Maybe a kick? I'd kick a pug.
I like pugs.
Me saying I'd kick a pug is going to get me never booked to the Spokane Comedy Club.
Yeah, you're done. Done for.
Fuck. I wouldn't actually kick a pug.
I said I was going to. I said.
You're going to murder
it. I didn't even say I was going to murder it. I said, my wife, Angela. I said, my girlfriend, Angela, my wife. There's some confusion. Was going to murder the dog. Not me. I said, the worst thing I said was I was going to leave my other dog alive so he could eat our faces when we were dead. No biggie. I'm not going to murder the dog.
You also wanted it to watch the other dog die?
Yeah, because I hated him and I wanted him to have psycho shoes falling out. She's like hanging.
Yeah, oh, that is.
She's like, I'm so uncomfortable. Guys.
That was like entirely.
You're totally off the edge, bud.
Oh, this pod is great.
This is going good.
I need to check the time again.
No, God, you're such a ninny. You know that's what they call a vagina, das puss.
So we're at an hour five of audio recording. I don't know how long it took me to start that.
Das puss in England. Have you ever seen Gordon Ramsay?
No.
That's another video you can look up. Is the animated Gordon Ramsay video where he flips the flips out. It's fun. I like it. I watch. If you ever like watch a YouTube video,
no,
and then like a week later you're like, I remember that video, but I didn't like it or save it. So like, I'll just go through my history, and then you start scrolling, and you're like, Jesus fuck, how do I watch so many fucking videos? And it's like it was 2 days ago, and there's 900 other videos in front of it. And like, what happened here? How did this occur?
Do you want to know what videos I watch?
No.
Go through my Pornhub history.
Ew. Ew. A bit.
Screaming goats. Screaming yotes. Screaming goats. Hippo farts. Stand-up comedy.
Yeah, me too.
Things we learned about Freddie Mercury after he died.
Oh, Jesus.
Turns out he was gay.
Nobody picked up on that.
Some Canadian stand-up comedy.
Ugh. It just gets worse.
Some American stand-up comedy, but filmed in Canada.
I hate comedy.
There's a video of Dave Attell at Just for Laughs like 20-something years ago.
Ugh.
He has hair, ugh, and it's really awkward because you can tell the crowd does not like feel what he's going for immediately. So
I feel like there's only one. The only filmed like Dave Attell thing was that road work special.
Mm. Yeah.
Where there's like they had cameramen on stage, and it was like
he just handed cameras to the to the audience.
It was like three different 20-minute sets, and he just went fucking.
Well, then he has that
murdered
the bumping mites, Mike. Bumping mites. Why do I keep saying mites?
Lumping types. Mikes
with Jeff Ross.
Flumping tykes.
Anyway, everybody, this has been Shark Tank and the Biscuit live.
I wanted to talk
from
about
Checkerboard
a
Bar
comedy thing.
Go ahead.
Wait.
It's 8:15.
What's that mean?
I could be at home eating.
You got
cookies.
you got a date?
I wish.
You got some shit to do? Huh?
I'm sad and alone.
Oh yeah. Isn't that weird that that's usually if you're the more sad and alone you are, the more likely you are to go home and eat five layer dip by yourself. You don't want. Hey, I had a story I forgot to tell. I was talking about comedy and a story. I'm just gonna keep you. I don't have to do anything tomorrow.
I have work.
Have you ever done that where you set up? So my sister throws these like elaborate parties.
Okay.
And she used to be dating like a really good friend of mine. Some would say best friend.
Until he fucked your sister?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. What a dick, right? I never fucked his sister. He had a whole bunch of them. He had a whole mess of sisters.
Like the chances I would accidentally were so much higher.
I mean, seriously. They were
I mean, they were eight, but still.
Well, they were all different. All different ages.
Ranging from 6 to 12.
No. Yeah, well, yeah.
I mean, at one point, maybe.
Anyway, I never banged any of his sisters. Let's see what she says about five-layer dip. A five-layer dip of sugar. Yes, please.
Like white sugar and brown sugar and powdered sugar.
No. Like
pudding and frosting.
A little of that cookie dough.
Oh, I had a parfait recently, which is kind of like that.
Yeah?
Layers of different puddings. It was delicious.
Nice.
Everyone loves a parfait.
Some whipped cream in there.
It's cookies and cream and chocolate.
Little coconut, toasted coconut on top. You like toasted coconut?
No, I'm not a fan.
Are you hungry? Oh, so hungry. Oh, what a sweetie.
Oh, it's my baby. Oh, my little packers. All right. If you didn't know there's dogs here, that'd be weird.
It looked like I was talking to your dick.
You hungry? You hungry?
What were we talking about?
You had a story and a comedy thing.
Oh, damn, the comedy thing. But up the comedy thing. Oh, no. Have you ever? Oh, my sister. I never fucked my sister. That's what we're talking about,
good.
Right? Yeah,
good.
Yeah.
A weird story. Saw this one time.
You're never going to guess what happened.
The odds were stacked against me, but.
I got in there. It just took several roofies and a whole bunch. Speaking of roofies and my sister.
Bill Cosby.
Yeah. Should we change the name of roofies to Cosby's?
Oh, I'll hand out some Cosby's.
Yeah. Okay, so my sister would throw these elaborate parties, right? And me and my boy, we're all living in the same place at the same time. Isn't that weird? I was living in the basement like a loser, like a fucking huge piece of fucking garbage. Like a trash, you know, trash piece of fucking slime. Just subhuman garbage person. Do you know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm saying? Okay, yeah. So I was living in the basement, and they're throwing this party. I can't remember what it was for. I think it was this party we used to do in August, Virgo party, because I know so many Virgos. Because I'm a Virgo. My dad's a Virgo.
You're a Virgo?
A Virgo. Yeah, his brother's
I'm
a Virgo.
I'm a Virgo.
You're a Virgo.
Are you me from the future?
Yeah, totally.
That's creepy.
No, I used to know. Tons of Virgos.
I've never had Virgo parties. I don't have friends.
They're stupid. Everybody just gets fucking obliterated in fights.
That sounds great.
Yeah. So anyway, we're having this party the next day. So me and Chris, that's my boy who fucked my sister for years. No, not that Chris.
This
different
Chris? Okay.
That's Angela's Chris. I have a Chris.
Okay.
Don't you have a Chris? Not everybody was. Everybody got a Chris.
There's that Chris that I voted against legalizing weed despite.
Chris Armitage.
Oh, I forgot about him.
Everybody did.
I don't like him.
He's a garbage.
Not a fan.
He's a trash man.
Chris, if you're watching this,
yeah, fuck
I'm not
life.
A fan.
Hang up the YouTube and get something done. Hang up the YouTube? That sounds like something like
my grandma would say.
No, you know, like at
that bitch is so old. She said, "Hang up the YouTube."
No, it's like at the beginning of the Mark Maron podcast where he's like, "Shut the gate," but instead
lock
of
the gate.
Lock the gate.
That's from instead the of, Almost Famous.
Instead of that, it would be like, "Hang up the YouTube."
You ever seen Almost Famous?
Yeah.
Where Mark Maron goes, I saw lock the gate.
No, I saw a moist anus. It was the porn porn version.
That Mark Maron also in
the, the picture of the cover was just two anuses instead of the two mirrored glasses. All right. What were we talking? Oh, yeah. So
see your sister.
Yeah. She's got this big, huge party planned, and all these people are showing up. Huge party. And me and Chris were like, let's drink some beers. So we're like, there's a bunch of beers here. Let's drink some beers. This is the night before.
Okay.
So we end up sitting in his front yard and drinking 800 beers at least. Just
literally
drinking beers and just bullshitting. And the in the day, the sun comes up. We're just drinking beers and people start like, people jogging by and leaving to go to work and stuff. We're just still sitting in the yard drinking beers, just fucking annihilated, and then crashed out. Then woke up at like 4 p.m. and Rachel had to do everything, all the work. And we're bad people. That's what I'm getting at here. You never done that before? You could do that with this podcast. Just sit here.
I have work in the morning.
Yeah, but you could just leave from here to work.
I have to have different pants at work. I can't wear jeans.
Oh yeah, those weird pants, huh?
They're black pants.
Blake, if you don't know, is a courier of human fluid. That's a pretty good description, right?
Yeah, I mean, you could.
Not a chauffeur.
You know how many times people are like, what do you do for work? And I can't say delivery driver. Yeah. What do you deliver? Like pizza? Kinda.
Sort of.
You know when you eat a pizza and then you have like you your stomach goes grr-grr-grr and like that wasn't good. That pizza must have been bad. And then you shit into a cup and take it to a doctor. That's what I drive around. I deliver that.
You deliver the horror. It's the horror, son. The horror. Welcome to the House of Horrors. All right. You know Stephen Wright?
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Yep.
Genius.
I was just listening to the Unmasked with Anthony Jeselnik, and he said Stephen Wright was his biggest influence.
Oh, yeah, of course.
One of his biggest influences.
Stephen Wright's better.
Stephen Wright has some bits that I can see you being heavily influenced by Stephen Wright.
He's a big dog.
It there's a lot of... What are you talking about this?
He's got like some comedy specials, not like specials, but like film, you know, comedy filmed on YouTube. You know, you can look up some of his stuff.
Yeah.
Right. And it's great. It's hilarious. It's awesome. One of them that always comes up, it's the weirdest thing. All right. Have you ever looked up Stephen Wright on YouTube? Are you looking it up right now? Is that what's happening?
Oh, God.
Like I'm being asked out over here.
I was listening to you, but I was also going to look up something on Facebook. Blade Frank, hope you're not watching this. Created a Google Drive document of Gary Goldman's comedy tips and posted a link to it on the Spokane page.
Oh, Jesus
and,
Christ.
And he's saying it like he discovered that Gary Goldman does, like, Gary Goldman's doing these tips. I don't, you know they're pretty good. They're aimed at everybody. You should. It's like, yeah, everybody that is on this page knows Gary Goldman's tips.
Everybody on earth has, even people that don't do comedy are like, Goldman, he's got some good tips. Life tips.
And I was going to show you a post that.
You're going to show me a post?
Yeah.
Welcome to Surfing Post with Blurf and Fleck Allen.
No, so this is Harry Riley on the Facebook group saying he likes your type of comedy.
Oh.
And then Mika Lahman responded.
Seriously? We're getting on the inside here?
It was positive. Yeah. I think you just hate her.
Oh, that's good. What's it say?
She said she saw somebody in back where she's living do 7 minutes, and it reminded her a lot of you because he was goofy and had good stage presence.
Right.
But it was a guy doing his first set ever. So somebody who's never done it before is what you are in her mind.
That's great.
Which is crazy because I don't think she has jokes.
Welcome to Roasty Mikalama.
She has no idea who I am.
Slurm and Flarb.
Nobody watches this podcast. Nobody knows what Marches means.
Have you ever seen Mika do sets?
I have. Not great. When I started, she was at the mic every week. She hosted like every other week.
Yeah.
It was
really good.
Yeah.
It was super awesome. I mean, I've never seen somebody who was that goofy with that good a stage presence before in my life. really just slaughtered. Are we talking
shit about Mika? Okay, so what I noticed was more than anyone else, she would go up and be like, well, I don't actually have a joke prepared.
Yeah.
She'd go up and be like, she'd go through her jokes and be like, well, yeah. I thought that was going to last 3 minutes, but it's 30 seconds, so yeah. I'm just gonna leave now.
Yeah. So I'm out of here.
Okay.
And then it's just dead silence, and then they're like, could you feature next week?
And she's like, of course. And then she came back on and said, oh, I was hosting. That's right. I need to fill the rest of the 7 minutes.
I forgot what I was doing. So Stephen Wright.
Right.
He's got all these videos on YouTube. And there's one that pops up. One of the, I guess, big ones or whatever. Hilarious. Right. But it's something about how the camera is set. You know, and he's got this, he's bald, right? So I got this bald spot going on, right? Mm-hmm. So that's all right, whatever. That's perfectly normal. Whatever. People
sure,
go bald.
Whatever. No, I, right, you tell yourself that, whatever. It's all right, no, it's perfectly bald. Normal. Everyone experiences
but
it.
He's got this, it's like he's bald here, and then there's a little bit more hair.
Okay.
But then it's bald back here, but it's like wrong. Like his head is shaped incorrectly or something. Like I can't, like it looks like an alien thing, like some sort of horror.
And there'll be
show.
A picture of it right here, hopefully. I don't know.
It's not there. I'm not gonna.
Yeah, that sounds like a lot of work. I'll probably put a poll in. Do you think Derek should do more editing on these videos? It'll be up in this corner.
It's not there.
It's not. That requires work. I forgot to write down the last day.
You should look it up. It's creepy. I mean, don't look at.
Not right now.
Maybe look.
Can we just be done?
Don't look it up right now.
I think we've been doing this well over an
hour. I have another story.
I thought that was your comedy thing and then your sister thing.
Oh, and then I had a story. The sister thing was just to drag this thing out.
I want 5-layer dip.
Oh, man.
Some like sour cream, some salsa, some guacamole.
You ever seen You're the Worst?
Some beans. You're the FX show?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What were your dips? Your five?
What was your You're the Worst reference?
Sour cream.
That show is awful.
Guacamole. Sour cream,
guacamole. Cheese.
Cheese.
Salsa.
Salsa.
Beans.
Beans. That's five.
That's five. Then he got some olives. And
olives are Mexican food. This is a very strange thing. I used to do it all the time, but it does not actually make sense.
You're right.
You ever been to a Mexican restaurant and put olives on something?
It's Italian.
Italian.
Yeah.
Which makes, I mean, Spanish, Italian, whatever.
Greek? Do the Greeks have olive oil?
They're all gay.
Yeah, probably.
Anyway, you know what I like? Little green onions on top. Now, is that a layer?
Yeah. If the olives count as a layer...
There's an episode of You're the Worst where they're talking about, I think they call it 7-layer dip. They were going for a 7-layer. Mm. And they couldn't figure out what the layer
was. That was like
one
of the first couple episodes, I think.
It was a good show.
I watched that show with my friend, and it's hard to get through.
I love that show. The only thing I didn't like was the last episode.
The worst.
The last episode was terrible.
Is it over?
Yeah, it's all done for. Doug Benson is on that show. He's so fucking funny.
Yeah, like he was all serious. Himself. Like, I have a business.
Yeah. This is my favorite. He's got this, like, really. There's a part where he's like, how much do you think you deserve to get paid? And the guy's like, I don't know, $300. And he goes, oh. He gets all excited. He's like, oh, deal. It's just this little mini. Little, anyway, I don't know. I just, that's the kind of acting.
Like what's the comedian that plays his secretary guy?
Your mom.
I like that guy.
Who?
Doug Benson's secretary, and You're the Worst.
Oh, yeah, it's some guy.
He's in a lot of things. He was in New Girl. He played the homeless guy in New Girl. But he has a...
Just tell me he's in New Girl.
Wait. Auster?
Remember, what's his name's in there? Paul F. Tompkins. I've heard he's a cock.
Paul F. Tompkins. I enjoy his comedy.
I think he's a fucking dildo. I hate him because he's got money. That's usually how it works with me. Hello, Flappy Head. What were we talking about?
Oh, it did end. That's sad.
What ended?
You're the worst.
What were we talking about? Stephen Wright's weird head. And five-layer dip. We should go for a 7. Get some meat in there. Oh, throw some fucking meat on top. A little ketchup. Stir that shit up. Put some Cheetos in there. Fuck, man. You can make yourself
Steve
a...
Steve
Agee.
So, going to his IMDb page, is Kevin Hart at the top. It's like, that is not the guy.
Did you see my... I put up one of those face gradient things today where it tells you who you look like because it shows you... You take a picture and then it, like, morphs your picture into some famous person.
Was it Kevin Hart?
No, it was Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah, just like
I look exactly like that guy. It was perfect. It's like it x-rayed my soul. I'm 30% black on the inside. That's what I'm saying. You think that's a good punchline?
Shark Tank and the Biscuit live at Checkerboard. We are done.
I have one more story.
Why? Okay, go ahead.
It's not a good story.
Is it like any of my stories that were off? We went on a big thing about cows with their buttholes.
My nipples are getting cold.
I didn't think the butthole thing was going to last that long.
My nipples are frozen, son. We've been outside for a long time.
I have to pee.
Yeah? So I should...
That's just fucking disgusting. Wait, save your story for next week.
No, I'm going to forget.
I'll write it down.
Sit the...
Okay, get to your story.
Sit the fuck down.
I want layer dip.
You want a one-layer dip? Just a just a tub of sour cream.
That sounds good.
Oh, man, I get going on some sour cream.
Have you had have you had Hot Wings Ruffles? Those would be good dipped in 7-layer dip.
Do you know what I had the other day? I wasn't expecting them to be as good as they were, but they were, like, ridiculously good. Was a jalapeno ranch Ruffles.
Mm.
Oh, man.
I like cheddar and jalapeno Cheetos. Your dog's fucking right now. Really, I'm not like, go to your story. Bro. We can talk dip some other time.
Yeah, these guys go at... This is about the time where they're, like, getting ready for bed, and she's like, get those pits over here, boy. Let me lick those fucking pits. And he's like, all right.
Can I get in on this?
And then she'll lick so hard that she has to stop and pant for like half an hour. She'll lick his dong too. It's gross.
I don't like the slurping sound. The sound is awful.
She like avoids the dong. She just licks around the dong. She used to lick his balls when he had balls. She would really get into those.
Okay.
I tried to make
what's
a joke
your
about it.
Go, tell your story.
I got a Amazon Fire Stick today.
Is that why your backpack is Amazon brand?
No, I borrowed that from my friend.
Yeah.
Like a year and a half ago. I'm not giving it back. That's what I'm saying. I stole it. I got an Amazon Fire Stick today.
Okay.
Pretty cool.
That's what we stuck around for?
That's my whole story.
I got to go. Okay.
No, wait. It's got a... Hold on. It's got Alexa in the remote so you can ask it stuff. And I was like, Alexa, blah, blah, I said something. Oh, no, I said, Alexa, will you record my voice and sell it to the Russians? And she's like, would you like me to make a note of that? And I was like, what? And she goes, I can make notes. If you just tell me to make a note, I'll make a note of something. And I was like, Alexa, my name's Derek, and I'm the dumbest person on earth, or I'm a stupid idiot or something like that. She was like, all right, I've made a note of it. And then I was like, well, what the fuck does that even mean? I was like, Alexa, where are my notes? And she's like, I don't know what you're talking about. and then I was like, what? And she's like, I don't know what you mean. And she's like, if you need something, just ask me about a thing. And I was like, who's a stupid idiot? And she's like, you told me Derek is the stupidest idiot on earth.
So she just like, remembers just facts you tell her?
Yeah, it's really weird.
And I asked her scary.
I asked her to tell me a joke. She told me this fucking, she put Jimmy Fallon on. He's a fucking idiot. Said some dumb shit, retard joke about... Did you look up Stephen Wright's head yet?
No, we're going to go.
Is this the end?
This is Shark Tank and the Biscuit.
Shark Tank and the Slit
at the
list.
Live at the Checkerboard Bar.
Checkerboard, Dad's house.